In the first question, the direction of magnetic field is given here, and this is the direction of electrons, right angles to it. So when electron is moving in this direction, so we know that by convention the current will flow in this direction. So this will be the direction of current. Now, if current is flowing in this direction and magnetic field is here, so let us apply the Fleming's left hand rule and see what is the direction of force, because force is calculated by Fleming's left hand rule. I've taken out my index finger. This is pointing the direction of magnetic field. Middle finger points the direction of current. Okay, then the thumb is representing the direction of force. And you can see that the thumb will point downwards. So the direction is into the page. Now in question number 2, there is a positively charged alpha particle. So what is alpha particle? Helium ion, doubly charged helium ion. So this is positively charged and it is projected towards west. So this west direction is the direction of flow of positive charge. So flow of positive charge, so that means it's the direction of conventional current. So this is the direction of current. And the question also says that it is deflected. Why will a thing get deflected? Because of force. So the deflection is in the direction of north side. So this is the direction of force, because deflection occurs because of force. So now I am going to use Fleming's left hand rule to find out the direction of magnetic field. So let me use my left hand, and here we have the direction of, this is the direction of force. My thumb is representing the direction of force. Okay, and my middle finger, that is representing the direction of, the middle finger is representing the direction of flow of charge, that is the direction of current. So this is your force, this is your current. So where is the index finger pointing? It is pointing upwards. So this is the direction of magnetic field. So which option is correct? D option, upward is the correct option. Thank you. Okay, now in question number 4, as you can see, the uniform magnetic field is directed into the paper. It is into the paper shown by these crosses. And there is a conductor XY, and this conductor is moving towards the right side. So that is why this V is there, which is showing you the direction of movement. So basically, the magnetic field is into the paper, the motion of the conductor is towards the right side. So we have to find out the direction of induced current in this case, the direction of induced current. For induced current, we will use the Fleming's right hand rule. So taking the right hand rule into consideration, so first of all, the direction of motion is shown by the thumb. So it is towards the right side. So I have pointed it towards the right side. Now I have the magnetic field which is directly pointing into the paper. So I will point it into the paper. Okay, now if I open my middle finger, you will see that it is pointing towards, from Y to X. So the direction of induced current is from Y to X. Now the question says further that what happens if you reverse, that means magnetic field, think that it is out of the paper and motion of the conductor is also reversed left side. So let us check this also. So motion of the conductor towards left side, so this is showing the thumb, showing the motion, and the magnetic field out of the paper. So it is out of the paper, index finger is showing. Now if I project my middle finger, I will see that again it is from Y to X. So there is no change in the direction, and again it is from Y to X. So the answer in both the cases will be y2x and y2x. See this question number 5. In this question number 5, there is a horizontal wire in which the current flows from east to west. So this is from east to west. That is the only thing given, and they are asking you that at which point around this wire will the magnetic field be from north to south, north to south in this direction. Assume that this is my conductor. So this is east, this is west, and now I will use my right hand thumb rule to find the direction of magnetic field. So right hand thumb rule I have used. So if you see in this right hand thumb rule, so this is the direction of current. So my curled fingers show you the direction of magnetic field. So if you see below the wire, you will see that it is from north to south, north to south. Okay, so the north to south direction of magnetic field is directly below the wire, directly below the wire. Thank you. So in question number 3, you will see that there is a chamber, okay, and in this chamber you are sitting over here in the chamber, so your back is towards this side. So let's say this side is your back, and so this becomes your back wall, this is your front wall. Okay, and the question says that there is an electron beam. The electron beam is moving from back to front wall, back to front wall. And we know that conventional current is always opposite to the electron beam direction, opposite to the direction of flow of electrons. So it will be from front to back wall. So if electron is from back to front wall, current will be from front to back wall. Okay, so current is in this direction. Now deflection, what does deflection represent? Deflection represents that there is a force. So this force is in the right direction, right side. So we are supposed to find the direction of magnetic field. So this is a clear case of Fleming's left hand rule. So using the Fleming's left hand rule, so let us do this. So this is my left hand. So here you have the force in the right direction. Okay. And then current is given. Current represented by middle finger. So this is from front to back wall. So front to back wall. So it will be represented like this. Front to back wall. Okay. So we have got two fingers. Now index finger will show us the direction of magnetic field. So I open. Where is it pointing? You can see it is pointing vertically downwards. Okay. So the direction of magnetic field is vertically downward. So your magnetic field is vertically downwards. Thank you.